So does Destiny. Oh my god, Destiny has so many ultras. They almost have the 3-3 upgrade as well. It is on the way right now. Dark Shrine currently coming down for Honor. So Honor, you know, if he can get some Dark Templars out, they may end up doing some pretty good work. But a Mind Control going off on a Colossus. There's only two back here. The Infestor's laying down the Fungal Waste. And oh my god, all the sentries going down. Colossus getting Mind Control left and right. And the Ultralis just cleaving through the Protoss Army. And there's nothing that Honor can do about it. He is warping an additional charge slot. So, once again, as you guys can see, charge slots, you know, fairly good against Ultralisks, believe it or not. And they are able to repel Destiny's army for now. In fact, forcing Destiny to go ahead and go with a Roach Warren. And of course, Roaches are very good against Zealots. So, wow, Honor warping in. Oh my god, he just dumped all of his gas into Archons. Wow, this is such an insane game of ZVP, guys. Obviously, a couple blunders by both sides, but I feel like this is almost reminiscent of the old Brood Wars style where Zergs would go for, you know, mass defilers and Ultralis, and the Protoss would get money Archons, just tons of Archons all over the map, and this is gonna be so crazy. I mean, there still hasn't really been one big obliterating battle where both armies just end up trading with each other, but there has been a lot of small skirmishes around the map so far. And I feel like at this point, Destiny has been able to climb himself back in this game. That's just amazing, guys. I remember I was saying in the beginning of this cast, if Destiny is able to come back in this game, despite how far behind he is right now, I would just say, you know, he is one of the best Zerg players ever. And kudos to him for doing so. So Destiny has done it. I think he's made a game out of this. However, Dark Templars here coming in with a mission. They want to shut down Destiny, and they want to try to end it right here, right now. And this is one of the late-game annoyances that Zergs do have to deal with that Protoss have in their arsenal. DTs. And what it forces Zerg to do is invest into Overseers. They have to throw Spores and Spines all over the place. It looks like, though, because Destiny does have Infestors, he will be able to vomit on those DTs. And the vomit does end up revealing cloaked units. So pretty good control, pretty good usage of his spells there, making good maximum efficiency out of the fungal growth. And who said Zerg doesn't have medics? The queens are coming out now to heal the ultras and giving them a little bit of a boost in HP, but we are still waiting for a big engagement at this moment. Remember, guys, it is currently 5 base to 5 base, so no, surprisingly, what the heck is going on here? A random Archon decides to just pop out and get mind controlled. Anyways, it is 5 base to 5 base, remember, guys. And Destiny, you know, he's shown here that you don't need to be ahead of 1 base against the Protoss. In fact, you can win if you're 1 base behind. He's defied the odds here, and it's all thanks to his great Infestor control. Once again, we may get treated to another awesome sight of Infestor control here. A big battle, Archons versus Ultralis. This is just insane. And Infestor's laying down Fungal and Mind Controls left and right. We have Archons fighting for the Swarm right now. Finally switching back and reverting control. And what a battle. Colossus now under control of the Swarm. It looks like Destiny's Colossus. Yes, that is Destiny's Colossus. Doing a lot of damage to their own Protoss units and finally relinquishing control, and Destiny mopping the middle of the map with his entire army. Oh my god. Destiny in firm control of this game. Now he's at 193 over 146 supply. Honor trying to buy himself back with some DT play, but he's got to get into the Spore Crawlers to be able to do anything. And it looks like Destiny just trying to buy himself a little bit of time with those Spores to pick off all the DT. So really good control back at home right here. And Honor making a bit of a march here. It's a little Zealot parade. Oh, Fungal stops the parade in its tracks. Honor trying to slice his way through with just pure Zealots. But, you know, when there's Roaches here, Roaches are fairly good against Zealots. In fact, they're the counter Zealot unit. And able to kill off all those Zealots fairly quickly is Destiny. Meanwhile, it looks like we also had some Infested Terran action down here. Remember, Infestors can burrow and they can move underground. Destiny was able to, it seems like he was able to do a little bit of damage to the Nexus, but not any permanent damage. And meanwhile, back in Honor's sixth tertiary expansion, we have massive Stargate production going down. Honor trying to make the tech switch and avoid Raze here, but the Voiders have to be very careful. If they end up running into the Infestors, they might get all fungled down. And oh my god, here comes the Infested Terrans. A fungal now would be huge! And a fungal goes down, and all the Void Rays are going to fall along with it. Oh no. Oh my god, Honor trying to hang on barely by the skin of his teeth, warping in Zealots at the very last minute to try to punch through the Roach army, but it's still not enough. Destiny has so many forces, but more Void Rays coming to join the battle. It looks like there is something to detect the Infestors here, but the Infestors able to launch a couple of fungal Infested Terrans and fungal growths. Oh my god, what a battle. What a battle we have here, ladies and gentlemen. Both players still have minerals and gas in the bank with which to produce new forces. Roaches from Destiny, though, managed to kill off the Nexus, and that is a big, big blow to Honor's economy. He will not have that extra base to mine from, and he's trying to chase down the Infestors right now, and I love how Destiny is essentially using Burrow special tactics, if you will, to his advantage. He's keeping the Protoss player Honor on the back foot, constantly attacking from two different angles. Look, the Infestors are spawning Infested Terrans inside this expansion. The Roaches are keeping the Zealots away from the Infestors, and Destiny is just microing this game so well. And look at that Burrow micro. My goodness, he is on top of things on point right now, and he's continually using that Burrow to keep his Roaches alive. Look at that. So smart. Finally, though, Honor's Observer running in. And that will be able to catch the Burrowed units in play. But what a game we have here, ladies and gentlemen. DT is coming in now in the mix, and Honor able to wipe out those Infestors, finally killing them all. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at that income tab now. It does seem like Honor still has the superior economy right now at 95 harvesters over 55. the one thing he does lack, however, is a number of nexuses, or nexi, if you will. Really only has income flowing in from one base at this moment, whereas Destiny has income flowing in from, well, it seems like he also has income flowing in from one base as well. So we are almost reaching that point in the game where the money is running dry, and neither player is going to have that much more money to fund the war effort anymore. And when it comes down to a situation like that, the units that win you the game are the units that use energy to deal damage, because they're recyclable. They take time to rebuild that energy. They don't require minerals or additional gas. And that's where the Infestors are really going to come into their own. Looks like Honor, though, manages to snipe off one of the hatcheries that we're mining. Big, big blow right there to Destiny's economy, and that was huge. Exactly what Honor needed to do. So those two Dark Templars fighting valiantly for Honor, able to kill off that mining hatchery for now. But good Jesus lordy, Destiny has so many Infestors. So many Infestors! He has so many, I mean, man, that can do so much damage. He's got Broodlords to back it up with Roaches and Hydras as well. That's not to say, though, that Honor doesn't have a pretty big army as well, and this has just been a back-and-forth game. Tug of war action almost. It looks like some Zerglings making their way in, able to snipe off the Templar archives. That is huge. There will not be additional Templars coming in this battle, and Honor seems like he is committing himself to this attack. This could be a very sticky situation because he will not be able to warp in additional Templar, and a huge fungal growth goes down. Destiny has so much fungal growth. This is gonna be insane. He's gonna be able to spawn so many Infested Terrans if he chooses to, but I don't even think he needs to. He has enough forces to just crush on through the Void Rays, and the entire army of Honor falls completely flat on his face. Destiny, so smart here, even using Burrow, could keep the drones alive. And he almost, I don't think he lost a single Infestor there. That is absolutely key. Those Infestors are going to be able to recycle that energy, and they'll be able to come back with maximum efficiency as time goes on. looks like we have a couple of Zerglings here bowing to the warp gate. Or perhaps they're just hiding because of the scary, scary DTs. Overseer comes in. It will be able to see the amount of DTs here, and I don't think Destiny is going to try to unburrow there. He'll probably just leave them burrowed for now. But what a game we have here, guys. Where are the warp gates For Honor, there we go, there's the warp gates. I was looking right at them. Honor has a lot of production capability. He's got probably about 20 warp gates in total. And he's got 6 or so stargates. So he can, you know, theoretically produce a lot of units. At the same time, you know, Destiny can't produce that much more because he's running low on minerals, but he has so many infestors, and that is absolutely key. Those infestors are going to be so money because of, you know, what I've said before, the efficiency, the recyclable energy, and Destiny here is going to come in with 8 infestors in Overlords, and oh my god, he can get so many probe kills here. Oh, Honor here, right on top of things, immediately pulling the probes out of the line, or pulling probes out of the way. Really smart play right there. A couple of DTs, though, however, making their way into Destiny's hatchery once again. On a mission to kill off that hatchery for another time. Destiny here, spawning a couple infested Terrans. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to do much. And, oh, if he doesn't get these infestors out of the way, an Observer could come in here and get a lot of free kills. But I think Destiny, a little bit smarter than that. He will be able to evacuate those infestors, but hello, a little bit of micro action here. Destiny trying to use fungal to reveal the DTs. Good placement on those fungal growths, and he's able to snipe off a couple of DTs here or there. So wow, this game is just going to the land of epic right now. And oh no, I did not just hear the mothership. A mothership has arrived. Oh my god, this game has just got every single unit possible now. Destiny coming in with a couple more infestors, but he doesn't have mind control, and you can mind control a mothership. Unfortunately, he doesn't have mind control, but he has enough infested Terrans here to possibly kill off this mothership. Honor's not paying attention. And there's the infested Terrans also inside this nexus as well. Oh my goodness, Honor here finally manages to pull away his mothership. Almost ended up losing a heavy, heavy and most expensive unit there, but he was able to save it. And oh wow, Destiny manages to kill off the Nexus at the 6 o'clock. This game is just going bonkers ballistic right now. And both armies now are no longer max, guys. If you guys notice, it is 147 to 156, and the reason for that is all the minerals on the map. Literally all the economy has been mined out. This is insane. This game honestly could go either way right now. If anything, though, I feel like Destiny has the advantage because of the pure infestor count he's got. But, you know, it's all, it could go either way. I don't know. This game, anything can happen. It looks like Honor, though, may be planning for a mass recall. I don't know if I agree with this, though. I really feel like Vortex would be better, but he manages to recall his entire army into this hatchery here. Now, the nice thing is he is going to have this ramp to fight on, but those infestors, man, they can get a lot of fungals down. And this is it. Honor has cornered himself into this location. There is no falling back from here, and a huge fungal growth goes down. The charge loss are just standing idly by, unable to attack because of the fungal, and this could very well be GG. Oh, my god, everything is just evaporating from the Hydras and Roaches. One Colossus left standing, but it ends up getting picked off almost immediately, and a beautiful play by Destiny, able to kill off so much. We even had Lynx kind of reposition themselves for a second there. Interesting. The mothership manages to make its way out. Huh. Cool. So the mothership was able to get out of the way. I thought for sure something, you know, was going to go down or something, but it manages to get out. So out of all the units that go in there, the one unit that you wouldn't expect to survive survives, and Honor able to escape with his lone mothership. But, you know, that's not much. Now, one thing that I feel like Honor could do so much better in this game is his, you know, get High Templars. I don't think I've seen him feedback or storm at all. And feedback and storm would be so good against this this army. We may actually end up seeing it here. Honor has a lot of Templars there. Oh, but they're gonna get mind controlled, and he feedbacks his brother and then feedbacks the mothership. Wow. Honor just says, nice one. And that's all you can really say about that, because Honor had an opportunity there to do so much damage with this Templar, but he let it whiff by him. Now he may end up getting some kind of storm here. Nice little storm, doing some pretty good damage. But wow, Destiny now I think is about to take this game moments away at the very least. But what an epic game we've had here. Let's just check some of these tabs. Workers killed, 58 workers killed for Honor, 77 probes killed for Destiny. Recall as well that Destiny had to climb back in this game after, you know, taking so much damage in the early game. We have a little Zergling doing a little bit of work in there, but I'm pretty sure that at this point, Destiny is just waiting and biding his time to make the final attack. He's got a lot of forces in the middle of the map, and he's just waiting it out for now, but I don't know why my mouse is like tripping out right now. If you guys hear that sound, it's like turning off and on. Anyways, Destiny is running in here with a couple of lings, and he's gonna be able to do some harass on these gateways. And yeah, I think Destiny right now, I think he knows he's won this game. At least I think he's won this game. You know, I called the game for Honor in the beginning, and it ended up being the complete opposite of what I thought. But as far as I know right now, I think Destiny's got this game in the bag. He's just playing it very conservatively. Doesn't want to, you know, lose, because he's not entirely sure how much army Honor's really got. But honestly, this is what Honor's got. This is it. 4 Templar, not really enough to do that much damage to this army in the middle. 4 Templar and a couple of Archons, and that's it. Anyway, some more Infested Terrans making their way in here. And Destiny gonna try to infest his way through the Protoss. just Infested Terrans shooting down the Protoss buildings here. And it looks like the Infestors will go ahead and make their way out. But yeah, at this point, I feel like Destiny may be allowing Honor to get back in this game a little bit, so to speak, because, you know, Honor is able to rebuild. He's been able to close that supply gap by a little bit, 139 under 173. I feel like Destiny may be giving him a slight chance to get back in it by using his Infestor's energy and not really attacking. And wow, that's a lot of Phoenix. I'm surprised that Honor decided to switch it up to Phoenix at the very end of this game. Huh. Now, Phoenix can be nice if he manages to Graviton Beam all the Infestors in the big battle, but because of the raw number of Hydras on the ground, I feel like Destiny will be able to do a lot of damage if that's what Honor tries to do, and oh my god, a huge Fungal goes down! Honor is just gonna lose all of his Phoenix! What a huge mistake right there, and a huge blunder by Honor. And Destiny now certainly has this game in the bag, starting to destroy the Protoss infrastructure from the inside out. And I'm not sure what Destiny is waiting for. I really am not sure, because wow, Honor is now going for carriers. The very last unit that you have not seen yet is the Almighty Carrier. He's even getting the Graviton Catapult. Now he is mining off one base, so I mean, he has enough gas and minerals here to make carriers for a little while, but this is it. This is the last hope for Honor. If his carriers come through for him, I am going to be so amazed. Because keep in mind, he's gonna have to keep him away from the Infestors, which have mind control. There's like over 12 of them, over 20 of them in the middle right here. And yeah, I mean, this is just gonna be crazy. Destiny slowly whittling away the Protoss infrastructure with his Infested Terrans here. And slowly buying time. Lings here. These Lings are finally destroying what remains of the architecture in the main. Remember, this used to be the main of the Protoss player. Look, all those warp gates going down. All the high energy, high tech buildings have gone down as well. But Honor doesn't care. He really doesn't care. You know, he knows that this is the last mineral spot on the map. And his only hope now is just to hang on, produce, I suppose, carriers is the unit of choice he's gone with, and try to win the game with carriers. That is his only hope. That's his last hope. Now, these changelings may end up making their way in if Honor is not paying attention, although I'd be very, very shocked if he wasn't, because, you know, he's only watching two bases right now, essentially. And yeah, he does end up killing those changelings, so the carriers are still undetected. And here we go. Unbelievably, Honor has nearly maxed himself out once again, now at 162 supply. So we are going to have yet another big Protoss versus Zerg engagement, this time with carriers to boot. And Honor does have Vortex Energy on that mothership, so this could be a pretty interesting one. All the Chargers running in, but a huge Fungal could go down. Feedback's getting launched on the Infestors. Destiny not really doing anything, finally launching a couple of Fungals here. And mind controlling, what did he mind control? I'm not entirely sure, it's so messy. He mind controlled the mothership! He mind controlled the mothership! And he's vortexing his own forces! Oh god, that's brutal. I think this has gotta be game here at this point. The mothership under control of Destiny's forces. Carrier here just kind of launching a lone interceptor one at a time, but it dies immediately as it comes out. And oh, the mothership falls. The most expensive piece of Protoss machinery goes down. And these carriers are getting picked apart one by one. And Honor, finally, with the, you know, valiant GG, and leaves this game. So, wow, that was probably one of the most epic Zerg versus Protoss I have gassed in a long, long time. 56 minutes long. I think that every unit in the Zerg tech tree and the Protoss tech tree was used this game. I'm pretty damn sure that every unit was used. I don't think there was a unit missing at all. So that in itself has to qualify as one of the most epic Zerg versus Protoss ever. And I think that was just a blast. That was amazing. What an amazing game. So I want to thank you guys all for tuning into this game. And I just have the biggest smile on my face right now because, I don't know, that was just fun. That was fun to watch. If you guys have great games like this, amateur or pro, send it into hdreplays@gmail.com. I will cast them. In fact, you know what? I have so many people that spam my email all the time with, you know, HD, cast this, HD, cast that. And, you know, usually I'll check through the replay and they'll be like, oh, this was epic. And usually it's just really bad. You know what? I think if I have time, I'm going to just pull out one of those games right now and just cast it for the hell of it. But anyways, I just want to thank you guys all for tuning in. I have the biggest smile right now because that was an amazing game. And please stay tuned, guys. We're going to have more games coming soon. I've got to practice more for MLG, but before I do that, I have got to get some rest. So yeah, that's it for me, guys. HD signing out till next time.